Welcome back, everybody. It's time for Dinner and a Movie with the one and only Debbie Matenopoulos.
I am
looking forward to this today. She's making the perfect one-pan chicken dinner. But what's the special occasion, Deb?
Well, I like to do Dinner and a Movie with my family. We all enjoy watching Hallmark and Hallmark Movies and Mysteries over the weekend and having a nice meal. But this weekend is extra special for me because my good friend Jill Wagner is starring in Hallmark Movies and Mysteries original film, Mystery 101, Playing Dead. She's a bit of a spirit animal to me. So, you know, we're both Southern girls. We love each other. So this weekend's a special viewing party at my home. This is for you, Jill.
I definitely see that between the two of you.
We love
you guys have a great connection. It's really fun. It's going to be extra special once they get a load of this.
All right, you're going to love this. You're going to be able to make this for Vanessa in no time. She's
going to
be super impressed. I'm telling you, the skills you're picking up on this show are really second to none, Cameron. So it starts with some sliced lemons. If you would just arrange those on a sheet.
You got that. Okay? I've got that in me.
Just with some parchment paper so it doesn't burn the bottom of the pan because it's going to be in there for a minute at
just
quite
like this?
High temperature, just like that. You're going to want to preheat your oven to 425.
Okay.
Take some of these tomatoes and
you
just
got
pour them out.
Pour
all
them out there? Am I being too precious with this?
No, it's supposed to be, you were being a little precious.
Okay.
It's supposed to be kind of rustic like this, okay?
Good.
Then just like that. Now, you could season these before you put them on the sheet tray or you could season them right now like we're going to do.
Got
just
it.
Sprinkle with some salt.
Yummy.
Just like this. Some pepper. Here you go, I'll give you the pepper.
How pretty that looks. Okay,
and
very
then
good.
Generously pour some olive oil over the whole lot.
Okay.
Well, you don't have to be that generous with the pepper.
That was a mistake. I spilled
No worries.
There's going to be one little area that's going to be a little extra spicy. Okay, here we go.
Take the olive oil. Now, you can be generous with that.
Well, I'm trying to be.
There you go. I know it's a little difficult getting out of that guy. All right, we're good. So set that aside. We're going to put some more in a little bit. All right, you can put that right here. So now what I've done is I've already. No, you're doing great. I've bought some chicken thighs with the skin on, and you want to pat them dry before you start this process.
Okay.
So pat your chicken thighs dry. Then you're going to salt and pepper these guys as well. What do
Very
we do
good.
With the pepper? Did you use it all over there? What'd
well,
you do?
I,
okay, here's the pepper. All right, salt and pepper these guys. Put the garlic all over it. And what I would do if I were at home, but I'm not going to get that messy here, I would take my hands and really rub the garlic on
the skin.
Do
you want me to do it? Should I do this?
Don't worry about it. I think the people at home understand. It'll be on our website. Now take some olive oil. Oh, gosh, and it really reeks like garlic.
Okay, very good.
Make sure you cover it.
Am I doing the right thing?
You're doing the right thing.
Okay, good. Great.
Take these tongs and place the chicken thighs on top of all those beautiful vegetables. I love using tomatoes right now because they blister in the oven and it's tomato season.
Mm.
The shallots are going to end up caramelizing, as will the lemon slices. It's really quite a beautiful recipe and very simple.
Fantastic.
And it's just infused with so much flavor.
Okay,
then
look
I take
at this.
Rosemary because I love rosemary so much. And you put it on top of the chicken. You put it around the chicken. If you could even sort of, you know, if you can get one inside of the between the chicken, the skin, and the actual meat.
Just to get the flavor going in there?
Just to get the flavor going.
Now, we're putting this in the oven.
Yep, at 425, like we said, for about 30 to 45 minutes. You know your oven, so just watch watch the oven.
But here's the question for you, and I'm going to take the other one out here.
Okay.
That'll take, and we're going to kind of jump ahead.
All right, do that.
How do you get that crispy exterior? Because you bake it for, what, you said about
30 to 45 minutes, depending on your oven.
But then I want that exterior to be crispy just like this. How did this happen?
What I have discovered after trying this many times is, first of all, you want to get your chicken dry. So that's going to be key once you get it dry. Secondly, you need to turn the broiler up for the last few minutes.
Yes.
And with vegetables like these, it doesn't matter because it's fine. You'll just get a little darkness on the tomatoes and they're going to blister even more.
Mm-hmm.
The shallots will do the same. And the lemons you're not going to eat anyway. If you're using other vegetables, I would maybe take the chicken off, put it in a separate pan, then pop it in for 2 minutes on broil. But again, watch it. You don't want it to burn. So we're going to set that aside for a minute. And I like to serve it with a beautiful salad that's in my cookbook, It's All Greek to Me. This is one of my favorite things that I have eaten my entire life growing up. It's just shredded cabbage and carrots. It's a very simple recipe. You put that in the refrigerator, let it get cold, and while it gets cold, you just make a very simple lado lemonal dressing, which is just olive oil, the juice of some lemons, some garlic again. Let me see if I put the garlic.
Will you say the name of the dressing one more time?
Lado lemono.
That's what I'm talking about.
Ladi means oil. Uh-huh. Lemoni means lemon. Lado lemono.
Lado lemoni. Lado lemoni.
There you go. Some salt, some pepper. You whisk that together until it emulsifies and it's beautiful. If you don't have, you know, lemon around, you just use some red wine vinegar, just like this.
Beautiful.
And you can also season it to taste when you're done. serve it up, and we're good to go. I'm going to toss that around.
While Deb serves up this plate of deliciousness, I want to fill everyone in on a Mystery 101,
okay.
Playing Dead, starring our friends, like we mentioned, Christopher Palaha and Joe Wagner. In the movie, a local theater is producing a murder mystery that becomes, well, a little bit more than just a show. Amy and Travis must uncover which character is playing for keeps.
That's right. We have a little trailer. You guys want to take a look? Take a look.
Revenge and reward. Getting back at someone and getting rich.
Sunday, June 23rd at 9, the professor and detective are coming back. The stage is set for the perfect crime.
They cut the wire.
It wasn't an accident.
It's like this elaborate puzzle for us to follow.
You were a little helpful.
Just a little.
Yeah.
I get a little.
Mystery 101, Playing Dead, an all-new signature mystery. Premieres Sunday, June 23rd at 9 on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.
How good does that look?
Right? Good does that look? And how good does this taste?
Oh, do you love it? Oh, Cameron,
I've already
so
been started.
Happy.
I mean, I'm getting into the whole dinner and movie thing already, Deb.
Try the cabbage carrot salad.
Absolutely genius. I love it.
So fresh.
That dressing is perfect. Right? I really mean that. I really mean that. So good. For the full recipe, go to HallmarkChannel.com and remember to watch Mystery 101 Playing Dead on Sunday, June 23rd at 9, 8 Central on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.